This is my camera comparison test of the new iPhone 15 Pro Max versus the 14 Pro versus the 13 Pro. Is it worth the upgrade or should you save your money? In this video, let's find out. Now, I shot a ton of photo and video samples for this comparison, but I'm not gonna waste your time. Let's cruise through these. Starting with photos, I'm gonna be honest. All three are gonna look very similar in most regards. It's actually only in a few key areas that we're gonna see a major leap forward. iPhone does an incredible job with HDR processing, and I think the colors look really nice. They're punchy and vibrant, but not too contrasty. They're easy to post on the socials without editing needed. Each phone has a triple rear camera system, from that crazy wide angle to the primary 1X, and it's only when we get to that telephoto lens that you should see that the new 5X on the 15 Pro Max has a tad more reach for improved clarity and sharpness on those zoom shots. But seriously, the 14 and 13 are still looking super good majority of the time.
We got a cool old Ford tractor. Let's do a little macro shot here. Wow, look at that. You can just keep getting in and in.
You'll often find that your own phone's shadow is gonna be blocking some of the light.
They're all pretty dang good. Super fun. I love macro.
Even the front-facing camera and portrait mode, they're looking almost the exact same across the board.
Ooh, guys, quick, check it out. iPhone is not perfect. They are good, but check it out, their camera, I just booted it up and it's showing a black screen. Oh, I wanted to show you guys a quick comparison of the 15 Pro Max versus the 15 Pro. Funny, it's so hard to even tell the difference between all of these devices, but anyway, check it out, that 5X optical that we got, that's new and only on the Max. Let's zoom all the way in, this house, bam. Oh, I need to go a little bit farther. There we go, 25X. Now on the non-Max, so we don't get that fancy new 5X, but check it out, it says 15X. We snap the shot, we'll zoom in on the roof a little bit. What do you guys think? Can you tell the difference? I would say, yeah, I could see the Max being just a tad hair sharper, but man, is it close. I don't think it's worth that larger in hand size and more expensive price tag, unless you like the bigger phones, then the Max might be a good fit, but I like the smaller ones, so I personally am gonna be sticking with the 15 Pro non-Max.
In low light, iPhone does a nice job of cleaning up the digital noise. There's not too much grain, nice colors and white balance, and keeps the details sharp throughout the zoom range. For a couple astro shots, from the ultra wide to the primary 1X, all three look really nice and very similar still. Now let's venture into my favorite, the video world.
What a gorgeous spot with some high dynamic range. It's bright and sunny out. It's a beautiful day. This is the selfie front-facing 4K 30 camera on all three. This is a great test to see how well is it doing with that HDR exposure of my face, but then also those bright highlights up in the sky and the details in the tree branches. Which one is looking the best to you guys? A quick little stabilization test.
Dang, I could honestly be mix matching these clips and we would never know. They are so similar.
And this is 4K video on the ultra wide rear facing on all three. Do they look pretty similar across the board? I said this in my last video, but one of my hopes and dreams is that these smartphone makers, including Apple, iPhone, that these ultra wides would get better and closer to replacing GoPros and action cameras. So that means better stabilization, maybe slightly wider field of view, and maybe a little bit sharper as well. Quick microphone comparison. This is the iPhone 15 Pro Max, iPhone 14 Pro, iPhone 13 Pro. I have a feeling that they all sound pretty similar, if not the same. What do you guys think?
I think this is great news for most people. If you already have the 14 or 13, then you might not need to upgrade. Or if you're coming from an older phone and you need to save some money, well then maybe you can buy one of these older models and know that you're still gonna get a great camera system. And on a side tangent, as someone who uses one of these phone cameras every day for my job, I'm a little bummed that we're not seeing these bigger jumps of improvement, but I guess that's the S-curve of technology evolution. I guess if you really want the very best zoom, either go with the 15 Pro Max, or even better, check out the S23 Ultra comparison. I just posted it. It's fascinating to watch.
One big update on the 15 Pro seems to be that new action mode has just been really improved. So how's it compared to the 14 in action mode? And then the 13, well, sadly, we don't have any. So can you actually spot or see any difference?
Make sure you guys come back for my full comparison of the 15 Pro versus GoPro, which is the king of stabilization. Do you think iPhone can replace it yet?
This is 2.8K with action mode and then 4K on the other. So you can see that it crops in quite a bit.
So I'm not positive if action mode received an update or it's just more noticeable on the 5X tele lens on the 15 Pro Max. Drop a comment down below if you know. Either way, it's looking pretty dang smooth and very impressive. In slow motion, it's basically all the same looking here. Colors and clarity and the details look pretty decent for only 1080p, but I'm dying until iPhone catches up to the Sony Xperia, which has 4K 120fps. Let me know if you want to see that camera comparison down below. In low light video, mostly the same here, except if I freeze frame, notice that the lens flare is possibly the worst on the 13, and then maybe slightly less noticeable on the 14 and 15, although it's still there. For noise, sharpness, all that other stuff, it's basically the same.
The mobile apps are almost the exact same across the board. Now there's only two major updates that I found that I really like. First is actually iOS 17, so if you get that, I believe anyone can get it, but there's sort of a built-in level. If you can see that little line on there, it's sort of like a bubble level to make sure that your shot is nice and even. I really like that. And then that second major update is only gonna be on, I believe, the 15 Pro and the Max and stuff like that. If you zoom way in, this is both for photo or video, you can sort of get lost in the shot of the context and, oh, where am I and stuff. But then on the newer ones, watch, as we zoom in, you'll notice up here, it sort of shows like a context menu. Now, old Samsung and Pixel, they've had this for years, but well done to iPhone for finally adding this in. And another cool feature on the new 15s, check it out. If we snap a regular photo, one, three, let's go ahead and preview that really pleasant looking frame. If we zoom in on the old, well, check it out. You've got a little bit of blurry background, but not much. And if you want to edit that after the fact, well, there's not much you can do as for the depth of field. Unless you use Google Photos, check it out. We can go into Edit and then over to Tools and then Blur, and bam, we've got artificial background blur. Now, it is not going to be as good. Check out that edge cutout. It's a little rough. It's kind of missing that background piece. There's no depth of data here, so it's never going to be as good. But something to know. So the 13 and 14, these are the only adjustments that we have. But on the new 15s, if we go ahead and edit, we can basically turn it into a portrait shot. Oh, wait. Just joking. Doesn't look like it works on the ultra wide. Oh, dang, that's super lame. Hang on, let me try another shot. Portrait, boom, takes a second. So we can tap, change our focus point after the fact, switch our f-stop around for more and less shallow depth of field effect. Zoom in, check those edges. Looks pretty good. I like that editing after the fact.
So how does the iPhone 15 Pro compare to the Galaxy or the new Pixel 8 Pro or the latest GoPro? Watch those videos next and I'll see you guys over there.